Okay. A lot of people, we talk about Chuckadilly Adventures, and I put some stuff on Facebook where we're cooking on the chimeneya. And everybody's like, we need a video. What are you talking about chimeneya? So I'm going to talk about chimeneya this evening. We're not at a state park where we pull in and cook on little grills and our cookers and stuff like that. We are just at the deer camp, very primitive. If you can tell, we just piled in here at deer camp. It's real primitive. So you have to do some primitive cooking. If the world goes south, I know I'm going to eat. I got to keep the tank going. And we do a lot of cooking and a lot of eating. So I'm going to explain the chimeneya. What we got cooking tonight on the grate, and it just rolls over like that, rolls off that way to the heat. You just keep it over the heat. Is you build a fire inside what we're calling chimeneya. And this is built probably 40 years ago before Atwood's ever had the high society chimeneya that you can go up there and buy you a little fireplace that you have a grate that rolls over your food. This was built by Peter Poole. It's a truck rim, a big truck rim with a smaller truck rim stuck inside and welded together. That's your base. Then he put a 1-inch pipe on it and welded that. And then you have a ring, a drum ring, or the slip-on ring for the old rims, and a piece of grating with an arm. And that's your whole chimeneya. And we cook steaks. We cook chicken.
Best steaks ever.
That's how I got my little nickname, Chuckadilly, is by cooking chicken on one of these. But tonight, we're cooking just regular old deer hamburger patties. And all I did was season them up with some salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, and put A1 across the top of them. And we're going to let them cook. I've got two bratwursts from Felsenthal Fish Company that their specialty is this brisket that he has cooked and shredded and stuffed in that shell. I've never had those. We're going to try them, but they're brisket bratwursts from Felsenthal Fish Company in Strong, Arkansas. The only place you can get them. It's his recipe. He needs to put a patent on it before people start stealing his ideas. Then we got some mushroom cap. But the thing is, you got to learn how to regulate on this stove. You got to be able to move your heat, move away from your heat, depending on how hot your fire is. You move off. Now I'm just letting it sit here and percolate for a little bit while we're cooking. We've been down here. We've got a trot line out, caught a couple fish. Susan's killed a deer, a good deer. So it's time to sit back, relax, and enjoy, cook a little bit on chimeneya and say, hey, God has been good to us. So after we get a little bit of cooking done, we'll come back and show you a little bit more about how well this chimeneya cooks compared to a regular grill.